Good morning, friends. It's Ms Stacy from Fernbrook Farms. I'm here in my house and I'm dreaming of the day I can go back to Fernbrook and get my hands in the dirt and enjoy the garden. And so I thought that we could have a story together about the secrets of the vegetable garden. And so if you want to take a seat and get comfy, we will view this excellent book together and read it. And there is a shine of light element, so you might be able to see some things in the background as I go through the pages. We'll see if I can get it to work. So it's called Secrets of the Vegetable Garden. It's by Carron Brown and Giordano Poloni, and I'm going to be reading it to my friend Bonaparte. There he is. So I'm going to be reading it to him as I read it to you. Hi, Bonaparte. Are you ready to hear the story? I'll show you the pictures as well. A vegetable garden grows under the sun. If you look closely between the stalks, between the leaves, and in the soil, you will spot the animals and plants living there. And this is where you can shine a torch behind the page or hold it to the light to reveal what is hidden in and around the vegetable garden. Discover a small world of great surprises. The seed of a tomato plant has been sown in soil in a pot. When it is grown into a seedling, it will be planted outside. What three things does the seed need to grow? Can you see them in this picture? Let's see if we shine the light behind this page, if we can see what's there. Do you see that? Did you guess water as one of the things that a seed needs to grow? What about sun and soil? You're right. Splish, splash, splash. The seed needs water, warmth, and soil to grow. Right, Bonaparte? Squawk! What's that flying in the sky? Birds who eat seeds planted in the garden take to the air. Why are they flying away? Why do you think they're flying away? What could be there? Let's see. Do you see what's there? Oh, wait, I have to bring it off. What's there, friends? Can you see what it is? Did you guess it was a scarecrow? A scarecrow stands tall in the garden. It looks like a person who scares birds away from the seeds. Flap, flap. The tomato plant's roots grow strong under the soil. Which creatures are in the soil? Let's see if we can shine the light behind this page and find out. Do you see anything? Ooh, what do you see? Did you see worms? You were right. Worms break down leaves and pieces of dead plants. This makes food for plants. Wriggle, wriggle. And rabbits like to eat the weeds that grow in the garden. The gardener pulls the weeds out because vegetables need space to grow. Can you see the gardener's tools? Let's see if we can see. What do we see in there? Can you see them? Creak! The gardener keeps tools in the shed. There's a spade for digging, a trowel for planting, a watering can for watering, and a rake for smoothing the soil. New leaves on the tomato plant reach up towards the sun. Who is sheltering under the leaves? Let's see if we can find out. Is that? You you see a little clue? Whirr, two ladybugs have flown to the green leaves. They are spotty beetles with wings. Yes, they are. And let's see, silken threads catch the light. Who could have made this web? Let's see if we can find that. I love this. Who could have made the web? Do you see him? Or her? Did you guess? It's a her. A spider pulls silk from inside her body to weave a web. The silk is sticky and strong to catch insects for her dinner. The pitter-patter of rain falls on the soil and the plants, helping them to grow. Which animals feed in the rain? Good question. Let's see if we can find out. Can you see them? Did you guess snails or slugs? You were right. Snails and slugs come out in the rain and eat the leafy vegetables and slither. Gardeners do not like animals eating their vegetables, and they can protect their plants with special coverings, special nets. And what's inside this one? Let's see. Let's see if we can find out. Ooh. What's in there, Chloe? Did you guess it was lettuce? You were right. It's lettuce. The gardener has covered it to protect it from slugs and snails. Tap, tap. It can't get in that glass. Ooh, what a pretty plant. Small insects called aphids like to eat the juicy leaves. But another animal likes to eat the aphids. Can you see what that is? Do you see? Rustle! Birds like this thrush peck insects off the plants. Oh, Bonaparte, what do you think? Hey, Bonaparte's very interesting. The tomato plant has grown flowers. Bees carry pollen from one flower to another. This helps the tomatoes grow. Let's see, where is the pollen? Can you see where the pollen is from behind the page? A bumblebee picks up sticky pollen on its furry body and visits the sweet-smelling flowers to sip nectar. What do you think, Bonaparte? Good. This plant is growing tall. Its tendrils twist around canes. What is growing in the pods? Ooh, Bonaparte wants to know. He gets to see first because the page is behind him. Let's see if you can see. What's growing in those pods? Do you see them? Miss Stacy loves these early vegetables. Peas. These are peas growing in the pods. Pop. Mm-mm. Green tomatoes are growing where the flowers once were. Can you see any other vegetables growing? Let's see. Can you see any other vegetables growing? Do you know what those are? What are those long, skinny ones? And those round ones, growing under the ground. Did you guess potatoes and carrots? You were right. Potatoes and carrots grow under the ground. Pumpkins and courgettes, or squash, grow above the soil. Who's nibbling a pumpkin leaf? Let's see who's nibbling that pumpkin leaf. Can you see? Did you guess it was a mouse? A mouse is snacking on a tasty leaf. Small animals find plenty to eat in a vegetable garden. Small animals like this one? Could it be? The vegetables are being harvested. Can you see which vegetables are in the wheelbarrow? Let's see which vegetables are in there. I think Bonaparte would be more interested in that mouse than he would in these vegetables, but that's good. More for us. Let's see. Can you see the vegetables in the wheelbarrow? Let's see. There they are. There are tomatoes, carrots, potatoes, cabbages, courgettes, and a pumpkin. Those squash courgettes, courgettes, I don't know. The harvested tomatoes are red and ripe. Sorry, friends. Look inside the fruit. Let's see. Gotta look inside the fruit. We can do that with our torch. Do you see inside the tomatoes now? What's in there? Tomatoes are full of seeds. Each seed can grow a new tomato plant. Chop! Nice. Some tomato seeds are saved so they can become new plants. The rest of the tomatoes are chopped up and put in a salad. The vegetable garden will grow until autumn. In spring, it will be time to sow seeds again. And in the back of the book, there are some definitions about some of the things that we saw in the stories. I'll move that light now, and we can look at these. Seed. A seed comes from the flower of a plant. If it has soil, heat, and sun, and water from rain or a watering can, it will grow into a new plant. What are these? Roots. Yes. A plant has roots that grow down into the soil. Roots take in water and food from the soil. The roots spread out and hold the plant in place. And what about what's running up the center of the plant? The stem grows up from the roots and is at the center of the plant, working like a straw, sucking up water and food to flowers, fruits, and leaves. And then our leaves. A leaf is flat to catch as much sunlight as possible. Food for the plant is made inside the leaf using water, sunshine, and food from the soil. And what about these? Everyone loves these flowers. A flower is brightly colored and has sweet nectar to attract animals. Parts of a flower can make a seed if an animal brings it pollen from another flower. Nectar. Flowers make a sugary liquid called nectar. Animals such as birds, insects, bats drink nectar, and a special insect uses its nectar to make honey. Bzzz. Pollen. A yellow powder called pollen sticks to a feeding animal in a flower. When the animal visits another flower, the pollen rubs off and this makes seeds in that flower. Fruit. In some plants, fruit grows from the flower. Inside the fruit are the seeds from which a new plant can grow. Tomatoes and aubergines or eggplants both grow from fruits, or both fruits rather. So that is our story, Secrets of the Vegetable Garden. Really enjoyed that shining, the light, and seeing what was behind each page. I found this book at my library. Maybe I can find more like this. I hope you enjoyed it. Let us know in the comments if you liked story time with Ms. Stacy and Bonaparte. Oh, well, sometimes when it's time to go to sleep, you get a story and look, he went to sleep. So sweet dreams to Bonaparte the Barn Cat, and have a very great and wonderful day to all of you. I hope you can get out into your garden, plant some seeds for this spring, and enjoy the beautiful day. And I'll see you all next time. Have a great day. Thank you. Miss you.